This is reality TV that works. Startups made in Kansas City.
I thought I was gonna get on a roll. We try to keep it fun around here if at all possible. All work and no play is too dull for us.
Well, the first challenge we had in a new market starting up SunSmart Technologies was actually becoming a household name so that everybody knew what it was we were doing. Because every time I told somebody our name was SunSmart, they said, "Sun what?" And I said, "SunSmart." And they said, "Sun what?" And it really took a while to drive it home. We've done a lot of advertising. We've got a huge referral program, which is really paying big dividends because we're not selling luxury equipment here or something you don't need. We're selling a necessity. So when people go solar, they usually tell their friends about it immediately. We get a lot of referral business from them. I always wanted to start my own business, but the key to starting your own business is you have to have the right product and you have to have the right partners. Luckily, I teamed up with the right guys, Carlo Miave and Ted Lasecki, and it became a win-win situation for all three of us.
We all originally met at another solar company where we kind of got to figure it out some, and then we had enough knowledge to actually go out on our own. With our background in engineering, it really does help because you really understand what's going on behind the scenes, so we understand how to build them, how to design them, and then there's a lot of supply chain that comes into it as well. So it's what has led us to our success is the marriage of knowledge of our project, how to design it, and then also how to sell and make it affordable to our customers.
The way we landed our first couple customers is we actually started going door to door, then we started actually talking to local businesses in the Gladstone area and finding as many small business owners as we can and explaining the opportunity to them. From there, we kind of took off.
A lot of the early challenges in big solar projects are funding, figuring out cash flows, and then also moving in large amounts of product, and you have to get it installed in a pretty quick amount of time. So if you design anything wrong or there's any holdups, you have a whole crew sitting there not working, and it costs a lot of money. So usually on those first ones, they take longer than you expect, and they're just not as smooth as the ones that we do now.
The issues for us being in a new market is definitely an education process, especially having a new technology. So we spend most of our time educating than we do selling people our product.
Most people don't realize that there's solar rebates out there. Most people don't realize that the utility company pays for it. Most people don't realize that the federal government's putting money out there. So really, we spend most of our time educating customers, and if that's the basis of your business, you're going to do really well. The reason why we started SunSmart Technologies here in Kansas City, Missouri, is we did see an opportunity. The local utility companies, KCP&L and Ameren, are state mandated to pay out the largest rebates in the entire United States. So our business model was to come out here and pass on solar energy to consumers, both business and residential, based on the opportunity and the idea that the money's available to them.
We looked at about 15 states, did a lot of research. There are pluses and minuses. One of the biggest minuses is the snow on a rooftop, but we found ways to work through it and around it safely. That combined with, they get actually a lot of sunlight compared to some other states, on top of really good incentive programs that make solar very affordable for our customers.
The state mandates that they pay about 50% of the project. Then there's also plenty of federal tax credits and there's some grants available. And there's opportunity on a sunny day like today where you can produce your own energy and you can stop paying utility bills. Rebates are actually paid from the utility company directly to us. We'll hold off on them so that you don't have to come out of pocket the money, so you're not taking out a giant loan like you would with other installation companies.
The power from the solar system on our roof is brought down through these two pieces of conduit. These pieces of equipment convert the solar energy into something that the building and the utility company can use. It goes through a series of safety points and safety switches. After the safety switches, it backfeeds directly into our existing building, and at this point, we can send power back into the utility grid, lowering our bill and eventually eliminating it.
Now you know why we sell solar.
This is actually our goal board. We had the salespeople and the three of us, we all put our goals up there so we knew what it was we were trying to achieve this month. My goal is for the company, for us all to sell a megawatt of solar this month, for me to be able to go back and see my sons every other weekend, no matter what, and to be debt-free and buy a new GTR. That'd be a good goal.
Looks like my goal is not work 12-hour days, and then it says 15-hour days, check. So I already established that goal, yeah. And then I have to take weekends off.
Much like Ted, just not to work so much, because, you know, starting a business, you do work. 80 to 100 hours a week, every week. And there's no day that you have off. Every day is something can happen. So if you want to start a business, be prepared to work very long, long days.
Yeah, I mean, you're going to put in 80-hour weeks every week until probably year number two. So it's fun, though. It's rewarding watching it grow.
A co-production of KCPT and Outposts Worldwide, at home in Kansas City. Production, post, content.